we had a brainstorm on personalization. We were looking for ways to offer personalized accessories in luxury cars. It had to be something unique and, of course, benefit from the advantages of 3D printing. Besides design, I'm also passionate about music. So when we started thinking about speaker grills, I was wondering if we could take music or a song and turn it into something 3D printable. There are certain patterns, rhythms, and contrasts in songs. The question is, how can we use these to create a unique design driven by music and turn something which is only audible into something visual and tactile? The most common graphical representation of music is a waveform which shows the amplitude or loudness of the audio in time. If we then add frequency as a third dimension, we get a spectrogram, which shows the frequencies and the amplitudes that make up a specific sound. By analyzing amplitude and frequency values in time, we also get information on the beat, pitch, or tonal color of a song, which might be linked to certain visual cues or shapes. We then had a brainstorm in which we generated ideas on how these variables could influence the design. Should time follow a certain path like a spiral, or should it be more linear or radial? Amplitude could, for example, determine the size, the height or rotation angle of certain elements, or maybe it could be a force that pushes surrounding elements away. The frequencies could be represented by different shapes or the smoothness of an object. Trebly high-pitched sound could generate sharp shapes, and bass sounds could be more rounded shapes, for example. If you would think of woven or knitted patterns, frequency could define if the thread should go over or under, or maybe if it should make a turn or a certain knot. It's not easy to imagine what the effect of music and the combination of these solutions would really look like. Procedural modeling is a design approach where you use algorithms to create complex designs and also rather quickly can develop variations of a design by changing certain parameters or the original input. By setting different behaviors for each variable in music, so finding ways to visualize amplitude and frequency, procedural modeling turned out to be the right approach to efficiently develop unique designs. Now we used existing songs as input, but it could be any kind of audio. We could have a design react to separate instrument tracks or even someone's voice. This is also true for the application. We now focused on speaker grills and cars, but the same methodology can be applied to any other product to make a unique and tangible object out of audio or any kind of personal input. Personalization in consumer goods is often limited to choosing between a set of variables, like for example colors. But as you can see, 3D printing can bring personalization to a whole other level. The input is original, the design language is new, and most important, the end product is unique.